working multidisciplinary teams. And for me, it's important because it's a future position. I will be working in teams that composed of people with different cultures, with different backgrounds, with nurses, with pharmacists, with physiotherapists. So for me, learning to work in teams like that was really the most valid experience I've had. So it's really not so much about the explicit knowledge that I got. I mean, for sure, I already forgot all the principles of modern finance that I learned 2 years ago, but it's really the passive knowledge that I gained from having those interactions that really going to stick with me. There were two the two parts of the MBA program that I found that were really, really useful to me and that I really enjoyed most. So the first part is summer internship projects. So summer internship projects are giving your MBA students to try to consolidate MBA part with the medical part. So basically, you use the knowledge and the theory and the concept that you learned in your MBA studies, and you try to apply them by working on real projects in the healthcare sector. So you can choose project in a hospital, you can choose project in a clinic, you can stay in Montreal, you can go to Paris. But you basically being involved on the projects that are pertinent and not fictitious, so the real problems that identify in the healthcare sector and you try to solve them. So it gives you a chance to kind of put on the shoes of the healthcare administrator or consultant to the healthcare administrator and test out your capabilities. So you get a field experience, and at the same time, you meet people who are presently working on those projects, or leaders in the field. For example, in my projects, I had a chance to interview the chiefs of medicine, to the chiefs of surgery, to the chiefs of cardiology. I also got a chance to speak to Dr. Arthur Porter, the CEO of the university. So really, it's an opportunity to have access to this pool of expertise and pool of talent that without an MBA program, I would not have. The second interesting experience that I had in my MBA classes was MBA Japan program. MBA Japan program is a unique basically, it's an intense summer program that consists of 3 classes over in 3 weeks, so it's very, very condensed. And what happens is that Miguel and me invite students that do an MBA program in Japan to come to Montreal to take classes with the students from Montreal. So for 3 weeks, you get a very brief but very intense exposure to Japanese students and Japanese culture because, again, you work with them in teams, you work with group projects, you interact with them, you go out with them, you go out activities with them. So it was a very interesting experience, which I would probably would have never gotten in Montreal. I would, God knows when I would go to Japan to get such an experience. So it was an interesting way to see how the culture is different from ours in terms of business etiquette, in terms of social etiquette. So it was a great experience. And I just posted some photos from that summer. I also would like to, maybe without going into too much technicalities, to talk a little bit about the summer internship project, just to give you an idea of the variety of projects that are available and what it is all about. So for example, in summer of 2007, I was working with the Montreal General Hospital oncology department. And the question that we were asking is what is the best way to deal with unscheduled patients that were arriving? And the department felt that it disturbed the workflow and increased the patient's waiting time. So in order to answer the question, I used simulation modeling. And simulation is a technique that is often used in business to answer a variety of questions. Basically, you use a software to build a virtual model of a system that you're trying to study. So for example, in my case, it was the oncology clinic of Montreal General Hospital. So you use the software, you build the virtual clinic on your computer. The better you know the software, the more complicated you can make the system. In my case, it was pretty simplistic. But basically, you can then run the model, and you can modify certain parameters, and you can measure the outcomes, such as, let's say, a patient's waiting time, and you see what works best, what doesn't work, and then you can propose solutions. So to me, this was a great experience because, A, I learned how oncology applications are different. I learned about the difficulties, the bottlenecks, and the process. I also learned that it is very, that it is very not easy to deal with uncertainties. And the scarcity of resources is real and how difficult it is to sometimes divide the allocation of resources between different units in the department. And I also learned how to use new software, which to me was pretty cool because I don't have any background in computer programming, so if I can do it, then anybody can. This is my friend Ilan. He's going to be graduating from MBA for next year, and I wanted him to present today, but unfortunately he couldn't. So I asked him to make a couple of slides about his project because it's a little bit more exotic than for me. He basically went to India to see in India to study tuberculosis outreach program, and he had certain questions that he wanted to answer with his project, but he. What he learned was so much more than that. He was really able to get very close and personal with the community where he was working with the physicians, with the patients, with the, he was really immersed, he really immersed himself into that experience. And he also posted some photos for you guys to see. He was able to answer the questions that he initially raised, but what also he learned is how another healthcare system operates. He learned about the challenges in that particular setting and the challenges that a healthcare provider has to deal with. And he had a lot of kind words to say about the deep around himself. Basically, what he says is that experience like that he would not be able to get in Montreal, even in the business setting here. And really to him, this was the best experience of his education and the best travel experience as well. And he felt that really without any MBA opening the doors for him to do a project like that, he would never be able to get so close and so personal to another healthcare system to study from really from the field. And without MBA as a background, he wouldn't be able to meaningfully engage into that project and really understand what it's all about. So he also gives his email if you have questions about his project and how he got, how he found this project. So what did I learn and what am I planning to do with my MBA degree? A lot of people ask me that. As I mentioned before, I do see myself as participating in administration in the future and have the dual role of clinician and manager. For now, my short-term goals is obviously to complete my clinical training, finish my residency, specialize if I decide to. However, even in my residency, I do feel that MBA will come in handy because I have a better understanding of the organizational structure of the hospital. I have a better understanding of our healthcare system, of the factors that shape the economic, political, social. My aspiration is to become a physician manager who practice in with the perspective of cost effectiveness, but at the same time keeping the quality of care and my patients as a primary focus. I strongly believe that our society needs managers who understand patient care, i.e. clinicians or healthcare. But at the same time, we do need physicians who understand business. Because if we want to keep our healthcare system sustainable and efficient, we have to deal with those issues. I thank you very much. I hope you gave a little bit of introduction and a glimpse on what MTNA program is all about. If you have any questions, you can ask now. Email me later.
I have a question.
The point was to actually learn the simulation and to learn how to